striking beauty at Blackwater National Wildlife Refuge.
Yeah, baby. Oh my God, that's a giant! Hurry up, get him out!
Mixes with a fish that might make you say, ew.
He has those teeth there, and he has teeth in here, and he's got a whole row of teeth in the bottom.
Northern snakeheads are drawing visitors to Dorchester County. This is Key Wallace Drive on a Wednesday, and it's now one of the hot spots in the Great Chesapeake Invasives Count.
I mean, just for the snakehead adventure, you know, we've heard a lot of stories about it, and just want to see how it feels to catch one.
Don't get them confused with snakes. We saw them too.
I'll go down fighting every day to try to make a difference, even if it's only one angler at a time.
Kaz Kenny and his partners with snakeheadlife.com also run a weekly podcast to educate people about what's happening in their local waters, and they took us fishing.
We have to educate the public of what we're seeing here. We've got to stop the moving of these fish to other areas. I mean, the problem we have had the last 10 years is guys come here from other places in the state. They think it's really neat to fill their cooler and take it back and dump them in their pond in their backyard. You know, then we have a rain and that pond runs over and it hits a stream that's connected to a trout stream, let's say. All of them snakeheads get washed into a new body of water simply because people are moving these fish.
These invasive fish with a protruding lower jaw and a mouthful of sharp teeth eat what we like to eat. Kenny showed a picture of a largemouth bass in a snakehead stomach. The push, take them home for dinner.
Eat them, don't move them.
David Sikorsky with Coastal Conservation Association Maryland started the Great Chesapeake Invasives Count. It runs from June until December using the iAngler Tournament app.
We're promoting a citizen science effort where folks that are just going fishing, have a smartphone, or even don't have one, can go out and catch a fish, take a picture, follow the directions.
Sikorsky says they want anglers to report three species: northern snakeheads, blue catfish, and flathead catfish.
So these fish are spreading. The snakeheads really were first found in Maryland in a pond in Crofton. These Eastern Shore snakeheads are from a different area. Genetically, we're finding out they're different. So knowing where they are and maybe some frequency with which we're interacting with them or the sizes can really help the biologists understand what's happening in the watershed.
Ray Gill from Ferndale, Maryland is back again.
They're a dominant species. I think the other fish species are starting to take a beating.
It's the first one Ray has caught, and listen, I've never held one either. This one checks in about 3 pounds. Many people call them hideous but delicious. It's a white flaky fish and it looks much more appetizing than when it's pulled out of the water.
Yeah, baby. Absolutely. Oh my Lord, look at that.
The more you eat, the better it is for the ecosystem.
And Eddie Brambler, owner of the Wolford store, will get you started if you're new to the area.
We don't hide any spots. We're always trying to help people out, show them where they can fish for snakeheads.
Gil, who's a firefighter in Baltimore County, says they're reeling in the ugly to help restore the beauty of Blackwater.
Back at the station, they filleted it, and then we had fish tacos, and they were tremendous. I mean, they were just delicious.
For Chesapeake Bay Media's Bay Bulletin, I'm Cheryl Costello.